During the month of June in 2022, we took a trip out west to view the Montana Rail Link. This road has been on my bucket list for a very long time, and this year I was finally able to go. And hopefully, this won't be my final trip out there either, as of course, you've all probably heard by now how the railroad currently stands. At this point, the Montana Rail Link has been operating for over 30 years, starting in 1987 as a lease agreement with the Burlington Northern. However, news has spread about the BNSF buying back the railroad, which made lots of people come out to Montana, including us, to see their final days of operation. It is unknown at this point when the buyout will take place, but it was better to make the trip sooner rather than later. But either way, I hope this won't be my last trip to this railroad. The train you are currently seeing is an eastbound coal load on the BNSF Forsyth Subdivision. The location we are at right now is Sarpy Junction. Currently, we are about 60 miles from the start of Montana Rail Link in Billings. After 10 hours of traveling, we soon reached the beginning of Montana Rail Link. On the next day, we'd finally get our first taste of the railroad in action. We're here in Columbus, Montana to view our first Montana Rail Link movements. First up is this westbound coal train. MRL handles lots of BNSF run-through traffic on their main line, hence why many of the trains you'll see on this line are BNSF powered. Of course, this is also a reason why BNSF wants it back, as the majority of the trains on the system aren't MRL exclusive. now for the train we set our sights on. MRL R LAUBOZ freight heads west out of Columbus. This train is a staple for standard cab power on MRL, and has two ST-40s on it for today's trip. A helper set was added to the front of the train in Livingston, providing assistance for the battle up Bozeman Pass.
Thank you.
following day, we're set up at Reed Point, and the Loyal to Bozeman is wasting no time heading west, with the same power as the day before. At Big Timber, we view the train heading under the Northern Pacific cantilever, now fitted with modern signals.
Thank you.
No helpers were required for the trip up Bozeman Pass today. Seen here with the SD-40s being the sole power west of Livingston. Set up at Bozeman Tunnel to view the Laurel Bozeman coming out of the west portal. However, before they could get through, the train would have to wait for the Missoula to Laurel manifest coming eastbound first, with two MRL aces hauling the train up the grade. are technically two Bozeman tunnels. The one on the right was built in 1884 by the Northern Pacific, but was abandoned when a shorter tunnel was built to the left of it in 1945, which is still used today by the railroad. The Laurel to Bozeman train is now on the move again, seen here exiting the west portal. This would be our final look at the Laurel Bozeman, but another train wasn't too far behind, and we would head a bit further west to see it. The unit train descends the pass westbound at West End. That's quite a mouthful, isn't it? With both these trains now well on their way west, we are now at the end of our coverage on Bozeman Pass. Be sure to stay tuned for part 2 of this series, where we will head out further west for more Montana Rail Link action. Thank you for watching.